So we know then that matter occupies space. Okay, you can stop. You want to do what? Here's our experiment. So this is what I want you to do.
Tanto if you wake up como una Coca-Cola in a bottle, y cuando lo abres, it goes up, y se cae.
¿En una Coca-Cola?
No, cuando está en como una botella, y cuando lo mueves, se va para y se
cae. Que sube. ¿Qué tiene una Coca-Cola? Tiene
una tapadera.
Y tiene gas. Es agua con gas. Entonces, si le haces así a la Coca-Cola, ¿qué sube? El gas sube.
Y también sí,
las burbujas. Ok, this is what I want you to do. Here we go. You ready?
Yeah.
Okay, here we go.
Getting higher.
Look at how much. Hold on, we're gonna let it, because right now the sand is going like this, and it's dancing too. But do you know what it's dancing to? What do you think?
Jiggling.
It's doing the popcorn.
popcorn.
Oh, wait. Look at Liam's finger. Now look at the jar and tell me where the sand is at. Move back a little bit so other people can see.
There is just what, Coco?
Okay, Alexis is touching it. Put your finger there, Alexis. Okay, now look. The sand did what?
Went down.
It sank. The water did what, Liam?
Rise.
It rise. And the rocks stayed at the
bottom.
So we know then that matter occupies space. Okay, you can stop. You want to do what? Here's our experiment. So this is what I want you to do.
Tanto if you wake up como una Coca-Cola in a bottle, y cuando lo abres, it goes up, y se cae.
¿En una Coca-Cola?
No, cuando está en como una botella, y cuando lo mueves, se va para aquí, y se cae.
Que sube. ¿Qué tiene una Coca-Cola? Tiene
una tapadera.
Y tiene gas. Es agua con gas. Entonces, si le haces así a la Coca-Cola, ¿qué sube? El gas sube. Las burbujas. Okay, this is what I want you to do. Here we go. You ready?
Here we go.
At the start of this, she says, "Here we go." And so I see the kids all gathered around her. And so I'm beginning with wondering sort of what came before, and see the they're all in a circle. She's in the center, the focus. And she's beginning to do this action, and I'm noticing where the kids' focus is. And right now all the kids are looking at what she's pouring.
It's getting higher.
Look at how much. Hold on, we're gonna let it,
And right here there's a kind of another shift. The kids are still observing and being kids, they begin to want to touch, and she kind of directs them to, I think it was this young boy over here, to stand back and hold on and to continue to look, and that's what they're doing.
Now the sand is going like this, and it's dancing too. But do you know what it's dancing to?
And at this point, there's another shift. So now the children's focus is on the teacher. And It's fun how she's beginning to embody sort of the material that she's working with. So she's being the sand with her body and doing this sort of mimicking of what's going on in the vase with her body and calling it dancing. And the kids are observing her and seeing sort of how she is demonstrating what perhaps the lesson is.
What do you think?
Box. Jiggling.
It's doing the popcorn.
popcorn.
Oh, wait. Look.
And I'm kind of going back a little bit. I was interested in that moment where the young boy here said jiggling, and that got the teacher's attention, and she kind of immediately looked at him and pointed.
Jiggling.
And there's this nice eye contact between her and the young boy, and she repeats what he says, sort of maybe affirming, yeah, jiggling, and she calls it something else, but she affirms what he said. And
it's doing the popcorn.
popcorn.
Oh, wait. Look.
And I paused here. So some of the boys here kind of picked up on the popcorn and kind of like doing a little popcorn movement and repeated what she said. It's kind of interesting that they're repeating the popcorn and not the jiggling. But at that point, there's another sort of immediate, and the popcorn kind of got interrupted because there's immediate another shift initiated by the teacher, and they're looking at something, and I'm kind of curious. I see the boy pointing, and so I'm kind of curious if he's the one that first recognized this shift, and he's the one that first noticed something for everyone to look at of a teacher. So I was just gonna go back and look at that a little bit.
Oh, wait, look at. It's doing the popcorn.
popcorn.
Oh, wait, look at Liam's finger.
I missed that the first time. So she did say, look at Leanne's finger. So it looks like the young boy first saw whatever it is they're looking at this point. I'm kind of a little distracted because I'm noticing, and I did notice the first time I watched this and I was interested in it because I know the last part of the scene has to do with this young girl here. And so I'm just kind of noticing her closeness to the teacher. The way she was kind of leaning on her shoulder and moving along with the teacher, kind of rocking a little bit back and forth with her, and also moving in closer to look as the teacher leans in closer, with her hand on the teacher's knee, and sort of matching some of the affect, the teacher's laughing, she's smiling a little bit. So that's something I guess I'd want to go back and just watch this through with just focusing on the two of them. As kind of the initial intention to watch it the first time through paying attention more to the larger group shifts. So that's what I was doing, and I just got a little distracted from that.
Oh, wait. Look at Leanne's finger. Now look at the jar and tell me where the sand is at. Move back a little bit so other people can see.
There's what, Coco?
Okay, Alexis is touching it. Put your finger there, Alexis. Okay, now look. The sand did what?
So she's saying look, and and it looks like still the focus of attention is on the jar. And she's asking a question about what the sand did. And it's kind of interesting, as she asks the questions, she's doing this, you know, embodied performance of what the sand did. But it looks like the kids are still focused on the jar itself at this point.
Went down.
It sank. The water did.
And so she finished her little performance of what the sand did, showing went down. Well, I think that the boy answered it went down, and she used the word it sank. And now they're all, I think, using their fingers to measure the change in the water, the sand. It's hard for me to see.
Yeah. Rise.
You rise. And the rocks stayed at the
bottom.
So I was kind of interested in this kind of shift here. They, she's again doing sort of with her hands this gesture to show what's happening with the sand and the rocks. And there's a lot more movement of the kids happening at this point. And with they're looking in different directions. Some are looking at her. I've kind of noticed that this little girl is she seems to kind of not be always following the same kind of directive gaze as the other kids, perhaps. I'd have to look at closer watching it again. And so there's a little bit more movement and restlessness of the bodies, and I'm not sure really what that is, if it's kids' restlessness or if it's wanting to kind of get in closer at this point. I'd have to watch it again, and or to get a, to say what it is. I notice that a girl to the left of the teacher is now kind of yawning.
At the
bottom.
So we know then that matter of.
And of course, so that girl, the young girl was yawning, and then it happened right at the moment of this.
So we know.
Them answering that it went to the bottom, and there's, you know, I'd want to watch that several times because there's something with a realization at this point, and this girl's kind of really shifted in terms of moving from this yawning and looking down. And to then playing with her hair.
So we know then.
And to her arm suddenly shooting up in the air. So she had what I think is a realization at that point. I didn't get to look at the transcript too closely. I know it has something to do with, I think, comparison to Coca-Cola. So there's this moment she makes this kind of comparison, and it's kind of maybe a really neat moment, a visual moment of learning, and sort of this moment where the light light bulb goes on.
Occupy space.
Yeah, so tired.
Occupy space.
And so at this point she recognizes the girl with her hand up, but she doesn't nominate her to speak.
Okay, you can stop. You can
do
it. You can. You want to do what? Here's our experiment. So this is what I want you to do.
And there continues to be a lot more movement, and it's interesting how this girl is still, you know, making this close observation here. Boys kind of playing around with this paper. Another girl's rolling back, and so it's definitely a different configuration from the very start. The focused observation with the teacher kind of announcing the start of the activity. I imagine before she started the activity, there was a lot of work to get the kids into that circle, just knowing for myself with teaching. But now we see more movement, but there's still at the same time where there's all this movement, the kids seem to be still talking about, you know, what's going on in that face, and are curious and making observations and so forth.
Como una Coca-Cola en un barro, y cuando lo abre se goes up y se cae.
¿En una Coca-Cola?
No, cuando está en como una botella y cuando se mueve, se va para aquí y se
cae. ¿Qué sube? ¿Qué tiene una Coca-Cola? ¿Tiene?
Una tapadera.
And so in terms of the shifts and the arrangements, this is the longest point where the teacher's more engaged with one student and kind of going back and forth, looking at her and looking at the rest of the children. And there's these gesturing going on, and I notice the young girl is kind of doing some of the hand gestures that the teacher does to mimic what she sees happening.
¿Qué sube? ¿Qué tiene una Coca-Cola? Tiene
una tapadera.
Y tiene gas. Es agua con gas. Entonces, si le haces así a la Coca-Cola, ¿qué sube? El gas sube.
Y también sí, es el
y
el
bueno,
las burbujas. Okay, this is what I want you to do.
And so within those few moments there was a shift from this interaction between the girl and the teacher looking and talking about what she sees and is saying, and then within that the teacher looking back out, well, at some point here, looking back out to the rest of the children, and they're gazing at the teacher. So there's this kind of shift from something the young girl realized to the teacher maybe affirming or expanding on and making a lesson for the class, sharing what she realized.
¿Qué sube? El gas sube.
Y también es
las
burbujas. Okay, this is what I want you to do.
And here there's definitely a shift with her announcing, this is what I want you to do. And the kids are kind of looking in different directions and holding their papers, and there's sort of this closing of this sequence around looking at the vase and teachers touching it, probably going to move it away. And you can see the shift into what's going to come next. So, if few diversions in there, but starting out, that's what I'd want to pay attention to, is kind of the shifts in orientations, attention, where the students are looking at the object, at the teacher, and who's getting the attention, who's being nominated, like that moment there where the teacher's pointing at the young boy. And there's a lot of just nice moments here where she's really strong sort of directives of where to, for the kids to look, like this moment right here where her arms just reached out very strongly and there's this expression on her face, and all the kids are just sort of like, oh, definitely something fascinating I should be paying attention to. So there's a lot of, I think, teacherness in those kinds of moments. How do you get the kids to attend? So I'm going to go back and I want to think a little bit more just about what's happening, I guess, with a young girl. And since I don't understand the Spanish, I'm going to read this transcript to make a little bit better sense of what her realization is, if that's what it really is. So I was interested in, okay, the bubbles. Teacher restates the bubbles in Spanish, mulling Spanish versus Spanglish. Lost bubbles, the bubbles, Spanglish. Oh, okay, so that's Spanglish. And I was kind of curious who said bubbles first. It looks like it was child four. And so now I want to watch it again, and I want to pay attention this time to this young girl and kind of see just her participation in this moment. And something I'm already a little bit interested in is the sort of the attachment she has to the teacher, the way she's sitting close to her, and yeah, I'll go from there.
Here we go. You ready?
Yeah.
Okay. Here we go. Here we go.
So from that beginning moment, she has her hand resting on the teacher's thigh. Actually, yeah, now that I'm doing this, I kind of like watching it without the sound to look at her body and the teacher's body. And at this point, the teacher's hovering forward to pour and there's this nice movement of the bodies, both hers and little girl's body, both kind of leaning in, and the direction of the girl's gaze to watch closely. And the little girl continues to lean a little bit more closely in, a little bit more closely in, as the teacher pours. And the teacher finishes pouring. And as soon as she, teacher sits back, and there was the simultaneous movement of the young girl sitting back and this young boy kind of moving in and placing his hand on the jar. And at that point, the teacher puts his hand and her hand on the boy, has him sit back. And here's where she does this sort of embodied sand dance. And this young girl has this nice expression here. She looks to the teacher, big eyes. You can see the whites out of the corner of her eyes, and there's a little smile there. And I guess I'd be interested in some of these moments of, since she's a Spanish-speaking student, if, you know, some of, definitely I would think pedagogically, this dancing and the movement she's doing, the teacher's doing, is helping to kind of illustrate what it is that she wants them to learn about this matter that they're looking at. And and so it's not all words that she's using, but I would think that the movement's helping to demonstrate the science concept, but also some of the vocabulary that is being used. And so I think that would be interesting in terms of how some of that, this embodied sort of demonstration is kind of maybe helping the girl to lead to this realization she has about Coca-Cola and the bubbles.